Hey you guys, and welcome back to this week's video. If you're new here, my name is Kate Lewis, and I am an owl hooting, magnum eating, scooter riding, handstand doing, kind of sort of show jumper from North Yorkshire. So you guys have already seen the title of this video, and I know I've had so many questions recently on where Harrier has been and what's been going on, so I think it's time we answered some. So if you follow me on Instagram, I think I've also discussed it on here as well, you will know that Harriet had an injury at the beginning of the year. So she was diagnosed with degenerative joint disease, which is basically early arthritis within the foot. So Harriet was treated for this, and the vets had high hopes that she would be coming back into work and would be absolutely fine to compete in things as normal, just receiving injections every 6 months to maintain the foot essentially, and to slow down the progressing arthritis and things. So she was medicated, and then she came home and I brought her back into work, and she felt incredible. But then unfortunately, a month and a half into the work, she sort of started to get this intermittent lameness again. But essentially that just means she was like perfectly sound one day, and then the next day she was just slightly off, like not hopping, I don't mean hopping lame or even like really sore, like she just wasn't quite right. And I noticed it more in her personality than I did in her gait. We took her back in, and unfortunately the medication just hadn't worked. It was really hard at first, because obviously it was like coming to terms with the fact that I was not going to jump this horse for a long time again. I'm probably not going to ride her for a long time. Obviously, I've been through stuff like this before, and that was really difficult for me. She wasn't an easy youngster at all. So since she was four, I've just been working so hard with her to, you know, try and produce her properly and, you know, correctly. I put a lot of work, time, effort, money into progressing her, and I was really loving last year taking her to shows. And I mean, she like qualified nationals, first attempt, triple clear in two different classes, and I just thought, like, this is my future horse, you know what I mean? Like, this is the horse that I'm gonna have for years and years to come and just do so many amazing things with. And it was really difficult to come to terms with the fact that that wasn't gonna happen. But the vets basically gave us some options and said, look, we can medicate again, we can medicate different things and stuff and see if it makes any difference. To which I sort of said, no, I think I've had enough of all this medication and stuff, and Harry's definitely had enough, she needs a break. So then we looked at putting her in foal. Now, putting horses into foal and breeding and everything in general is something I have never done before and never really even considered. So it was something completely new to us. And it all sort of happened in that day, in that moment. Like, the farrier was there and he was going to do all her shoes again to support her for her arthritis, and we ended up just taking her shoes off. It just felt like it all happened so quickly. When we got home, it was a case of looking for stallions. We also made the decision then that if Harry was going into foal, that we would try and put Madge in foal as well, as Madge has had a couple of foals before, so we assumed like Madge will be really fertile and, you know, she would love a foal, she'd make a great mum. And Harry and Madge are very attached, so we figured that if they're pregnant together, then things will work out a lot better. So then we looked into studs for them to go to, because obviously we didn't want to do it all ourselves at home and stuff, because we're not experienced in this area at all, and it's not something that I would ever like play around with no knowledge. Stallion wise, we came to a decision that we were going to go with Conthargos for Harry, and for Madge we decided to use a more local stallion called Cascade. So once we'd chosen our stallions, it was time to send the mares off to stud and find out where they are in their cycles and how quickly we could get going. Hey guys, and welcome back to another vlog. Hi Harry. So while you guys are watching this, something very exciting is happening. Madge and Harry are going to stud today,
We are trying to get them both in fall this year. This is why I've been so stressed and excited recently and nervous at the same time. But yeah, we are taking them in this morning. I gave them both a bath last night, so they're all like fresh. I say fresh, Madge, your head is covered in poo. They are ready to go, aren't you? So they're going to stud for a week, so I'm really going to miss them. Hopefully, in a couple of weeks, fingers crossed, they'll both be in foal, but I'm probably, I don't know if you'll ever get to see this video or anything, but I will probably share it with you guys anyway, even if they don't take, because I think it's a good like life experience. It would be our first foals. So yeah, I am nervous, I'm excited, I don't know what to expect. Madge, shut up, I'm vlogging. Let's go. God, you're so dramatic. Where's Mo? Hi Mo. Hi Harold.
I've been to all this from you
this
morning. Oh, cop. Don't you, Fubs?
Oh,
don't you? Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
they both hate me.
You're having a hug. Whether you like it or not, you're having a hug because I don't get to see you for a week. Well, I will probably.
Hey guys, so we have just got back from the stud and it all seems so real now. We've left the mares there, they are going to be there for about a week. They were scanned on arrival to see where they were at in their ovulation cycle, and Harriet is still not ovulating. She wasn't a couple of weeks ago, but she might be coming back into ovulation soon, but they are going to give her an injection later on this evening, which will bring her back into her cycle, which will make her ovulate. And Madge is ovulating now. So it's all systems go with Madge. Madge will be inseminated tomorrow morning. So the semen is coming from the other side of Yorkshire. We are in Yorkshire at the moment. And yeah, it will be there for 9 o'clock in the morning and they're gonna inseminate her tomorrow. I really want them to get into foal this year as well. Like, I'd love it if they both take together because then they'd have one another throughout the pregnancy. And yeah, I would love it if they both take this year, but I'll be terrified the entire pregnancy. And yeah, I'll be a nervous wreck, but it is exciting, but at the same time, it's so scary.
So we obviously decided to keep the mares together for that 2 weeks. We could have obviously picked Madge up a few days later after we dropped her off, but we didn't want to leave Harry on her own. It seemed as though Harry was a lot slower to ovulate. Then it was time to go and pick them up, and obviously Madge was inseminated straight away, and the horses have a 2 week scan which determines whether they are in foal or not. Since 2 weeks had passed, the day we were going to pick them up was the day of Madge's first scan.
So today's the day. Harriet and Madge have been at stud for 2 weeks now. Madge was inseminated when she initially went in, so today is Madge's 2 week scan, which will show if she's in foal or not, so it's a big day. And Harriet was inseminated on Sunday. It is now Friday, so Harriet will have to go in like a week and a bit in order to determine whether she's in foal yet, but they've both been inseminated and they're coming home today. And I'm so happy because I've missed them so much more than I ever thought I would have done. Oh no! What's up with you here? Come here! Come here! Neen! Come here! So we've arrived, so it's time to go and find my babies. So now we have to try and find them. It's a big yard. Not in there. Are they where they were when they arrived?
Fancy,
yeah. Baby! Hiya!
Hiya, Mo. Hi,
oh my goodness, you're a pen together! How's that happened? Oh.
Oh, she's still just as miserable.
Come on, Misty, I have to give you a hug.
Oh, here's a bat.
So
lovely.
Gonna smile, you too? Harry's like, ew.
Hey guys, so it's the next day to when I was talking to you yesterday, and I don't know what has happened to my face. What is that? It looks like a spot, but I swear to God that was not there this morning. And yeah, I look like a mess, so I apologize in advance. I just wanted to basically update you on yesterday. So I didn't vlog anymore yesterday because I wasn't really in the mood, I guess. Madge is not in foal, not yet anyway. She has one more chance apparently this year. They're going to AI her again this week. AI basically means artificial insemination, for those of you who are even more clueless than I am. So I am gutted, really, because I really thought it was going to work and I was kind of hopeful about it because, like, she's had two foals in the past, but the insemination was... What is wrong with my face? The insemination was complicated with Madge, as the first batch of semen that came was not very good at all.
Something did go wrong with Madge's first insemination. The semen they sent from the stud that Cascade was at, the first batch was not very good quality, because the extender that they had used to transport this chilled semen had basically killed off all the sperm. So there was about 10% mobility rate with this semen, which obviously doesn't give you a very high chance of pregnancy, but Madge was literally ovulating then, and you've only got like a small window with insemination that you can use, so therefore we had to put the semen in her. But then the next day we were able to go and get fresh, and obviously fresh has a much higher mobility rate, so she would have quite a high chance of pregnancy. So basically Madge had to be lavaged, which is basically where they flush her out to get all of the other semen out and they put the fresh semen in. But obviously lavaging her made her a little bit inflamed inside, so then she had a bad reaction to the second lot of semen, which obviously meant that she didn't take. So we decided to take Madge in again and give her a second chance. But in the meantime, 2 weeks had then passed for Harriet, so it was time for Harriet to go in and have her scan.
Hey guys, so today's the day. Today is the day where we find out whether Harriet scans in foal. It's been 2 weeks since her insemination. Basically, I was so full of hope when we took Madge in, but since Madge wasn't in foal, we've just kind of been really down about it, and, like, I don't have high hopes. I don't think that Harry's in foal. Her behaviour's been a little bit different recently, but I think that's just because Madge isn't here. Madge is at the stud, being inseminated again for her last chance of the year. Really hoping that today is different, but I don't have high hopes. I've kind of, like, given up. So, yeah, that's pretty much where we're at.
I know what you're thinking, don't even think it now. No misbelieving, No one believing but me, tired and deceiving the life I need.
So obviously we were absolutely gutted to find out that Harriet wasn't in full. Like, I don't know, I think on the day I kind of put this face on of like, I don't think she's gonna be in full, I don't think she is, but inside I really, really thought that she was. I was absolutely gutted. So that was supposed to be Harriet's last chance, but I had a word with my dad and my mum. We rang Elite Stallions to see where we would stand with the stud agreement, and they agreed they would let us have just one more chance for Harriet this year. So we took her back in and had her re-inseminated, and because we had her re-inseminated on the last day of Conthargos's breeding season, so the last day they were collecting from Conthargos, we managed to get chilled semen for Harriet. So then Madge was being inseminated for the second time, and we were supposed to be using Cascade again, but unfortunately they must have used the same extender that they used the first time, because when the semen arrived it was the same quality as the very first set, which was like the 10% mobility rate, so a 10% chance essentially, which was just not something we were willing to go with again. So we ended up with a very last minute change of stallion for Madge, and ended up going with the stallion that they had at Beechwood Stud, which was called Classic. Classic actually passed away about 20 years ago, so all that was remaining from him obviously was Frozen, but his Frozen semen was extremely good quality, so we decided that we would go with the Frozen semen from Classic and switch Madge onto a Frozen cycle, which basically is a bit harder for the vets to do than a chilled cycle. With chilled you have a slightly bigger window to inseminate, whereas with Frozen it's a very specific time. It could be like 2 in the morning, 4 in the morning, it could literally be any time of day or night that they have to inseminate. That's what we decided to do with Madge, and Harriet was re-inseminated to Conthargos. So finally, the day of reckoning came for Madge first, because she was inseminated, well, re-inseminated before Harry was. So we took Madge in to see if we were lucky second time round. Hey guys, so today is the day we've been waiting for 2 weeks now, since I last vlogged to you. Today is the day Madge is going in to hopefully be scanned in full, although I don't have any hopes. We've been discussing it for the last few days of like what we think the outcome's gonna be, and I'm to the point now when I don't think we're gonna get a full this year. Well, we're definitely not gonna get a full this year, but I don't think they're going to be in full this year. So I don't really know what to make of it all. I'm just kind of really, I don't know, I feel very defeated by the whole topic. So as much as I'd love to come out here today and be like, yeah, like, oh, Madge is in full and stuff, like, I just don't think it's going to happen this year. So I'm feeling pretty, fell over a hose pipe. I'm feeling pretty defeated, to be honest. Yeah, coming back with Harry last time was really depressing, because I honestly thought that Harry would be in full. But obviously she wasn't, so she has been re-inseminated with chilled semen this time. But yeah, we're just gonna have everything crossed for her. This will be Madge's last chance ever, so that's kind of sad, because I know that Madge would make an amazing mum, and it's really sad to think that she may not take this year, but who knows. So we were absolutely gutted that Madge was not in full second time round. She was like coming back into season again, so obviously she hadn't taken, but They said that they would have her back in a few days later just to check, because sometimes an embryo can be late developing and they show up as not pregnant, and then they come back a couple of days later and show up as pregnant. But basically, she was not pregnant on the day we took her in. All of this journey, everything we've been through over the last few months with mares and with trying to get them in foal, all really comes down to today. Today is the day we are taking Harriet through to be scanned to see if she's in foal. Hey guys, so today is the day. It is Harriet's final scan of this year if she's not in foal, which I'm pretty skeptical, not gonna lie. Obviously we haven't had any luck so far. They did say that last time we were in there, the semen they've put in Harry is the best they've had at the stud all year, with like a 70% plus like mobility rate. So I don't know, but as I said, I'm feeling pretty skeptical, not gonna lie. It would be nice to have a good result today. I'm trying to stay positive, but I'm kind of just giving up, I guess. So let's go to the stud. So we are nearly at the stud again. I thought we were just taking Harry today, but it turns out we have to take Madge as well, because sometimes they develop an embryo a little bit later. So we're basically just taking Madge in to double check that she's definitely not in foal. But Harry is going in for her scan to see if she is in foal. So for the very last time this year, guys.
Oh, she's there! Harry! Harry, shut up! Shush!
Come on,
right, Moose, let's go! Let's go!
How long will I love you? As long as stars are above you. Longer if I can. How long will I be with you? As long as the sea is bound to wash upon the sand. How long will I want you? As long as you want me to. Longer by far. How long will I give to you? As long as I live through you. However long you say. How long will I love you? As long as stars are above you. Longer if I may. How long will I love you? As long as stars are above you.